Hello! Today we will discuss signal modulation. What is modulation? Modulation occurs if one signal modifies another. We call the modifying signal a modulator, the modified signal a carrier. Modulation changes a certain characteristic of the carrier signal, like frequency or amplitude. In this video, we will focus on amplitude modulation. The carrier and the modulator waves are not simply added together if amplitude modulation occurs. Instead, the modulator envelopes the carrier wave. This is what happens in the spectrum. It shows the carrier frequency with two new peaks nearby. These are called sidebands. One is at the carrier frequency plus the modulator frequency. The other is at the carrier frequency minus the modulator frequency. Sidebands are usually at both sides of the carrier frequency, but one may be missing or have a different amplitude than the other. There may also be more sidebands farther away from the carrier frequency. Amplitude modulation is very common in vibration diagnostics. For example, it often happens to bearing fault frequencies. Let's examine a ball bearing with 7 balls. The inner race rotates at the speed frequency of 25 Hz. The outer race is stationary. Each time a ball passes a fault on the inner race or the outer race, it generates a shock. For introduction, we will first show you examples without modulation. If there is a single fault on the outer race only, shocks repeat with the outer race ball pass frequency, BPFO. It is the frequency with which balls pass a fault. It is roughly 64 Hz in our case. Let's see what it looks like. The BPFO is clearly visible in the demodulated spectrum, along with its harmonics. We point at the first 8 of them in the graph. The spectrum measurement also shows the BPFO and its harmonics. However, low-frequency harmonics usually have a very low amplitude. They may be invisible. The visible peaks are the highest near the resonant frequency of the bearing and its housing, which is about 5 kHz. Now, if we add a fault to the inner race, there will be two sets of shocks. The inner race shocks have a smaller amplitude, as we can see in the graph showing the shocks. This is because the outer race is closer to the sensor used for measurement. The zoomed time signal clearly shows both sets of shocks, one for the outer race, the other for the inner race. The new set repeats with the inner race ball pass frequency, BPFI, which is 110 Hz. The demodulated spectrum shows both frequencies and harmonics of the BPFO and the BPFI. We would see something similar if the number of faults on both races was greater. It does not matter how many faults are there. They repeat. Therefore, we see the important frequencies in the demodulated spectrum. What must happen in a bearing for modulation to happen? It could be due to unbalance of the shaft. This unbalance acts on the bearing elements with a centrifugal force Fc. As the shaft rotates, it pushes more in the direction of the force and less in the opposite direction. Each time a ball passes a fault on the outer race, the force creating a shock is different. Let's look at a measurement of a bearing with only one fault on the outer race. The time signal clearly shows the amplitude of the shocks is variable. It is modulated by the speed frequency of the rotating shaft. The demodulated spectrum shows the BPFO and its harmonics. Modulation is shown as sidebands near these frequencies. This is what it looks like if there is a fault on the outer race and on the inner race. The outer race shocks are modulated like in the previous example. The inner race shocks are not, because the fault on the inner race rotates with the shaft. Therefore, the force acting on the fault is always the same. Let's look at a measurement of this situation. These are the outer race shocks. Their amplitude is variable due to modulation. These are the inner race shocks, which are all the same. The BPFO and its harmonics in the demodulated spectrum have sidebands as before. The BPFI and its harmonics do not have sidebands. There is another influence which may modulate the amplitude of shocks. Weight. Because of gravity, the weight of the horizontal shaft acts with a downward force Fg. It puts more pressure on the bearing balls under it than above. Shocks produced there are stronger. This is true for both races. In this case, only inner race shocks are modulated. The outer race shocks are not modulated. It is because the position of each outer race fault relative to Fg is constant. If there is unbalance and a force due to the shaft's weight, they add together. Modulation happens to the outer race shocks and to the inner race shocks. It is because the sum of the forces, Fs, changes as the shaft rotates. Therefore, forces acting on faults on both races are variable. We can even see this variability in the time signal. When the sum of the forces is the highest, the shocks are the strongest. When it is the lowest, the shocks are the weakest. Let's zoom into the demodulated spectrum and look for sidebands. Both BPFO and BPFI have sidebands, as do their harmonics. Let's show them individually. These are the harmonics of the BPFO and sidebands. And these are the harmonics of the BPFI with sidebands. We must note that this almost never happens. The centrifugal force from unbalance is usually much larger than the downward force of gravity. When examining bearing faults, unbalance is usually behind modulation. Effect of the shaft's weight is negligible compared to the effect of unbalance. This is all for today. Thank you for watching.